All right, guys, this is Bob Buskirk here at Think Computers, and I'm with Bill here from Corsair, and he's going to tell us about their latest product, which is the Corsair Voyager Air.
Thank you. We just launched the Voyager Air tonight. I want to tell you about it. It is the very first combination network-attached storage device and portable wireless drive, along with being a USB drive and a wireless hub. You know, what's really important about this, and it's a new category for Corsair, you know, a mobile storage device, it's a hard drive, but it's designed for use at home to be integrated into a home network, and all of the devices on your home network can access it, and on the go with a big rechargeable battery and with Wi-Fi built inside. You know, it is essentially a portable Linux server. You know, that works both at home and on the road. It's designed, you know, for wireless use. It's designed to use iOS and Android, tablets and smartphones. So we've developed a custom app for tablets and smartphones. The iOS app is already available. The Android app will be available very soon.
And now for this product, when will it be available?
It will ship before the end of this month. So they are making it in the factory right now.
And you have two price points?
Yes. We have a 500 gigabyte drive for $179.99 and a 1 terabyte drive for $219.99.
This is George here with Corsair, and he's showing us their latest case, which is the Obsidian 900D. And you could just go ahead and tell us all about this brand new case.
All right, cool, thanks. When we launched the 800D about 3.5 years ago, a lot of people really loved it. We changed a lot of things in the case industry. But after that, I started reading on the forums, and you know, for every 1,000 or 2,000 guys that love it, there's always a few guys who said, oh, I wish you guys had done this. So for the past 3 years, I've been keeping kind of a mental checklist of all the things they said they wish we'd done, and that's kind of what this case is come from. So for example, with the 800D, they said, you know, it'd be nice if you guys made it a little bit bigger for more water cooling. So instead of just a single 360, which is what the 800D had, you can fit a 480 or 420 up top, and then you can put a second 480 or 420 down here, a 240 over there, a 360 or a 240 in the front, and a 140 or 120 in the back. So you can do up to 5 rads in there at the same time. So that's a little bit over and above what the people have asked for, but we figured, you know, it's not hard to do if you just think about it when you build it. The other thing they asked for was better air cooling. If you wanted to do an air-cooled system instead of water cooling, let's get better airflow. So we have 3 120-millimeter front intake fans, which gives you a lot better airflow path, and we've taken out one of the hard drive cages here so you get a natural airflow path to the 680s. If you take out this other cage, you get dual 120s blowing right across your video cards, as well as the capacity to do a ton of exhaust here as well. So there's a lot of airflow. The other side, we have 10 PCI slots in the back. We have compatibility for dual processor motherboards. We have a hot swap base still down here, which is SATA 3 compatible. USB 3 ports on the front like standard. And basically keeping all the same tool-free, easy-to-build things we always wanted to do. We keep the same removing the side panel latch with a button in the back that we had on 800D. Works really well. And then this new side panel on the bottom is magnetic here. And then you can just change out your fan filters, which are magnetic on this section, and then you can update for your radiator, or actually, even if you don't want a radiator down here and you pull these hard drive cages out, you put fans down here, you get a lot of cold air intake from that side that goes up into the case, and then you can exhaust out the top. So you get front and side bottom intake, and then you can just blow up through that, and that doesn't affect your big side panel window, which is included with the case. So it's a pretty big chassis. It's about 15 to 20% bigger than the 800D. We also wanted to answer some questions. People asked for more aluminum in that build. So these new structural elements here and here are cast aluminum, and the front is a brushed aluminum finish. So it's a really elegant design, very sturdy. As a result, it's actually pretty heavy. It's designed to be more of a piece of furniture type of chassis and not so much like a LAN party case. So if you take this to LAN parties, you have my respect. But I would not be lugging this to LAN parties. Empty, it weighs about 40 pounds. So full, it weighs significantly more, especially if you water cool it.
Okay, and now when will this actually be available?
This should be available on the channel late February, and it'll cost about $350 US.